There are a lot of benefits to social media marketing. One of the most important is that you don't have to front any cash for most social media services. Of course, there's a downside. Most services require significant investment of time to get things started and maintain your social media campaign. Here's a quick look at a few of the pros and cons. The audience for social media is huge. In early 2012, Facebook claimed almost 800 million active users, half of which log in on any given day. Twitter claims more than 100 million registered, and even narrowly focused networking sites claim hundreds of thousands of visitors. Basic marketing focuses on the need for branding, name recognition, visibility, presence, or top-of-mind awareness. However you want to look at it, you want people to remember your company name when they're in need of your product or service. Social media services of almost every type are excellent ways to build your brand. Another pro is that social media is a long-term commitment. Other than little experiments or pilot projects, don't bother starting with social media unless you plan on sticking around. Any short-term benefits aren't worth the effort you have to make. To build effective relationships in social media, you'll need to establish your expertise, participate regularly, avoid overt self-promotion, and provide value with links, resources, and unbiased information. You'll also want to stay away from hard sell pressure techniques. Watch for steady growth in the number of followers on a particular service, the number of people who recommend your site to others, increased download of white papers, or repeat visits to your site. They're all signs you're building relationships that may later lead to increased sales and recommendations. How you use social media depends on the nature of your business. Think about leveraging the applications to promptly detect or correct customer problems or complaints, or use social media as a way to get customer feedback and input on new product designs or changes. It's also a great way to provide tech support to many people at one time, improve service and delivery, locate qualified new vendors, and more. Conventional thinking says that social media is designed for long-term engagement, for marketing and branding, rather than for sales. But a few obvious selling opportunities still exist, especially for business-to-consumer companies. You can include a link to your online store, offer promotion codes or special deals to your followers, or offer a way for people to sign up to receive your company's newsletter. We all know that time is money. But the magic word here is free. If you're a startup company, free social media is likely the only advertising you can afford. If you decide to approach social media for this reason, create a master campaign just as carefully as you would a real one. Make sure you outline target markets, ad offers, publishing venues, and the like. If needed, conduct comparative testing of messages, graphics, and offers. Monitor your results and focus on the outlets that work best at driving qualified visits that lead to conversations. And finally, supplement your free advertising with search optimization, press releases, and other forms of free promotion. For all its upsides, social media has its downsides. Sure, it's gained in popularity, but it has also become increasingly difficult to gain visibility among its hundreds of millions of users. By far, the biggest downside is the amount of time you need to invest to see results. You need to make an ongoing commitment to review and respond to comments, and to provide an ongoing stream of new material. Your initial commitment of setting up a profile is just the tip of the iceberg.